India and Israel discussed cooperation for the development of the advanced defense technologies, with a focus on the unmanned systems during the Defence Ministerial bilateral meeting in India on Thursday. According to the Indian media Economic Times of India, Indian Defence Minister Rajnath Singh and his counterpart Benjamin Gantz met intending to further strengthen the existing framework of the Indo-Israeli defense cooperation architecture. The two sides discussed issues concerning the bilateral and regional matters, as well as the existing military activities being conducted like a joint development and the training. A cooperation agreement has been signed between the Indian DRDO and Israel's Director of Defense R&D, which will enable the expansion of the technological collaborations and development between the countries, an Israeli embassy spokesperson said in a statement. The minister discussed the partnership within the government-to-government frameworks, military training, and technological cooperation with focus on UAVs and defensive capabilities, said the spokesperson. India has had close military relations with Israel, with joint projects underway like air defense missile systems and advanced electronics. Israel is among the top suppliers of the military equipment to India. With contracts for drones, radars, and ammunition being placed in the past, several Israeli companies have formed joint venture with Indian defense players to target Make in India projects of the Defense Ministry of India. India has placed its first order of the indigenously developed aerospace missiles in a move that will cut dependency on the Russian for the munitions and give the bulk of its fighter jets a combat edge that was missing during the Balakot airstrike engagements with the Pakistan Air Force. According to the Indian Media Economic Times of India, the order worth of ₹2,971 crores for the Astra MK-1 Beyond Visual Range BVR air-to-air missile system was signed by the Bharat Electronic Limited of India for an undisclosed number of missiles. These will be fitted on board the Su-30 MK fighter jets on the Indian Air Force, as well as the naval MiG-29K or KUB carrier-borne combat aircrafts. Developed by the Defence Research Organisation of India, now the DRDO, Astra MK-1 outranges the current set of Russian-origin air-to-air missiles being used by the Air Force that was found wanting during an aerial face-off in the aftermath of the Balakot airstrike in 2019. In the counter-strike attempt, Pakistan Air Force F-16s equipped with the US-supplied AIM-120 missiles could lock on and fire at the Indian Sukhoi 30 MKIs from across the border, while the Sukhois were not hit as they were performed evasive maneuvers, according to the Economic Times of India. The Indian jets could not strike back on F-16 as they remained out of range. The DRDO developed the missile has a range of over 100 kilometers, giving the Air Force extended time to take on their threats from across the border. These missiles are set to progressively replace all the Russian imports of long-range air-to-air missiles in the future, and further variants are being developed that will take their targets range beyond 200 kilometers. Besides, the Astra will be integrated on board the Tejas light combat aircraft MK-1A that is currently under production by the HAL, as well as the future indigenously developed fighter jets of India. It is, however, unlikely to be integrated with Rafale fighter jets in the immediate future due to the technical reasons. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and please support us by clicking the thanks button below our video. The Chinese naval capabilities are back in focus as satellite images reveals an all-new class of Chinese submarines docked somewhere at the Huludao port in Liaoning province of China. These reports, unconfirmed by the PLA Navy, comes amid the enhanced Chinese activity in the Indo-Pacific region. The military experts believe that the vessel spotted in the Chinese shipyard in recently obtained satellite photographs could be a new or upgraded class of nuclear-powered attack submarines. The submarine seen in the dry dock in Huludao port of Liaoning province, as per the image obtained by the Reuters. However, it is unclear whether the submarine seen in the image is a brand new design or an improvement of an older vessel or something entirely different. The military observers have been keeping a close eye on the Chinese since a Pentagon report in 2021 on November predicted that the Chinese Navy will likely develop a new attack submarine with vertical launch tubes for the cruise missiles in coming years. The vertical launch system, or the VLS, is a modern missile firing system used on the submarines and surface ships. A VLS is scaled down versions of the launch system built for the ballistic missiles aboard SSBNs. The VLS is designed for firing cruise missiles like the American Tomahawk. A VLS allows an SSN nuclear power attack submarine to develop the larger weapons with greater variety than the torpedo tubes. As far as the countries other than US are concerned, India has to be cautious, particularly with its Indian airfields or the Indian Air Force airfields, whose positions are well known and will be easy targets, said the Vice Admiral retired Shekhar Sinha to the Eurasian Times. The Indian Air Force has shelled $4.5 billion plan to modernize its Sukhoi Su-30 MKI fighter jet fleet due to the ongoing military crisis between Russia and Ukraine, according to the Indian news agency ANI. The Indian Air Force planned to upgrade 85 Su-30 MKI fighter jets with more powerful radars and cutting-edge electronic warfare capabilities in collaboration with Hindustan Aeronautical Limited, a state defense manufacturer that manufactures and supplies the Su-30 fighter jets. According to the reports, the plans to acquire 12 sophisticated Su-30 MKI aircraft will also put on hold. The Su-30 MKIs are the backbone of the Indian Air Force, with 272 of them are ordered in various batches to the Indian Air Force repeated orders for 30 to 40 of these planes whenever a shortfall of the fighter jets in service was noted. In 2020, the following India-China border tension, India's Ministry of Defense approved the purchase of 21 MH-29 and 12 Su-30 MKI fighter jets and upgraded to 59 existing MH-29s for $2.4 billion. However, experts previously questioned India's reasoning for choosing the MH-29 fighter jets over the latest Rafale jets. Tom Cooper, an aviation expert, questioned why the Indian Air Force performed Su-30s and MH-29s over the advanced Rafale fighter jets. Su-30, while formidable on the paper, lacks a performance and combat capability when compared to the Rafale fighter jets or even the MH-29 fighter jets, according to Cooper. The MH-29s are superior in performance in difficult situations over the bigger Sukhoi fighter jets is no longer a secret. He also reminded that during the Kargil War of India in 1999 and the Balakot airstrike in 2019, the Sukhoi Su-30 fighter jets failed to make an impression and India instead leaned on the aging Dassault Mirage 2000 fighter jets. Cooper also stated that while the MH-29 performed better than the Su-30 MKIs, it is not still the best option for the Indian Air Force. The MH-29s that India hopes to buy from Russia are old models that will be refurbished before being handed over, and they are simply not adequate for the job. Nevertheless, the latest development is a concerning matter for Indian Air Force, which is already dealing with a dwindling combat fleet. It has 32 squadrons instead of sanctioned 42. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. And please support us by clicking the thanks button below our video.